described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Learning Seed presents Supermarkets, Aisles of Persuasion. A young man walks into a large store where a young woman picks up a loaf of bread. The man carries a full basket of things, then pushes a shopping cart.
Sometimes you love it, and other times, not so much.
He takes a note taped to a refrigerator.
Some people even shop online or at pricey convenience stores just to avoid it. But sooner or later, everyone ends up going to a supermarket. A supermarket is a large, self-service market that sells food and household goods. Consumers around the world spend almost $2 trillion at supermarkets each year. In this program, we examine how supermarkets are designed to sell you as much as possible, as often as possible. Then, we show some smart tricks to avoid being taken advantage of by these strategies. The next time you go to the supermarket.
Title: What's the Big Idea? A globe sits in a shopping cart.
Supermarkets are a global phenomenon. The United States alone has more than 35,000 of them. The average American supermarket brings in about $500,000 each week. How did we get from this to this?
Small shops to huge markets.
For centuries, groceries were sold by small, independently owned markets, general stores, and trading posts. They had a little space and a few products. But when the package and frozen food industries exploded, along with the baby boom and suburban sprawl, the supermarket industry followed.
Archival footage shows early supermarkets.
Shoppers liked the convenient parking and one-stop shopping. And it became too difficult for mom-and-pop stores to compete. Most went out of business.
A store is damned closed.
Others were taken over by huge national supermarket chains. Today, most people shop at supermarkets about twice a week. Supermarket owners and the growers and manufacturers who supply them with products are in business to make a profit. Profit is the money that's left after a company pays for the items it sold, pays for its employees, pays its rent, and all its other costs. Profit margins in the supermarket industry are low, so supermarkets need to sell a lot in order to make money. Stores constantly track customer habits to find new ways to get people into their stores and to buy more once they're there.
Loyalty cards and coupons.
The more supermarkets know about how and why you choose what you do, the more money they can get you to spend.
A register displays almost $130 due.
Let's take a look at how a supermarket begins selling to you, even before you walk in the door.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.